Compare the two functions to determine which function has a negative rate of change. Let's take a look. Function 1, you have a $50 gift card. Hey, that's great. And you spend $5 per week. Let the balance of the gift card be a function of the number of weeks. So the balance of the gift card, that means the amount left. So if you're starting with $50, that's the initial. And you're spending $5 per week, you're taking $5 off the initial amount of the gift card each time. So that is a negative initial, negative 5. Okay, so one more time. The balance is $50 to start with. That's the initial value. You're spending $5 per week, so you're taking $5 off each week. So for that function of the balance of the gift card for the number of weeks, well, you're spending $5 each time, which is a negative rate of change. Function 2, you borrow $200 from your parents to purchase a bicycle, then pay them back $40 per week. Let the total amount you pay them be a function of the number of weeks. So the total amount you pay them is a function of the number of weeks. So the amount you pay them, well, you borrow $200, you pay them $40 a week, but at zero, you don't necessarily pay anything. You're going to pay them back $40 in 1 week. So the amount you pay them, let me make a little table to help visualize this. And you can make a graph if you want it also. In fact, you could do the same for this function one if it helps. You just do whatever you need to do to help understand the situation more clearly so you can solve the problem intelligently. You borrow $200 from your parents and you're going to pay them back. Let's say the input is the weeks and the output is the dollars. So for 0 weeks, you pay them back $0. 1 week, you pay them back $40. 2 weeks, you pay them back $80. 3 weeks, you pay them back $120, and so on and so forth. So right here, your amount of change is 40, and then divided by the change in the inputs, which is 1, is 40 divided by 1, which is 40. So your rate of change here is plus 40. So this is a positive rate of change. Function 1 had the negative. So you're going to choose function 1 here. So the important takeaway here is if you have a verbal situation and you're having a hard time figuring it out, make a T-chart, draw a graph, use another representation that's more visual to help you process what's going on.